She says, if I wanted to feel sorry for myself, I'd have stayed with your father.
Ooh, that is quite a drop. Let me help you down.
I've got this. That's three.
What? Oh, please.
Three times I saved your life. The sinkhole, your foot. What? You'd be dead if my mom hadn't taught me to dress a wound. Fine. Two times then. The sinkhole and just now.
Hey, let me see that.
Leave it. It's nothing. Hey, I'm fine.
Come on. Roll up your sleeve and just admit we're friends already.
This is not an admission.
Let me see. It's getting worse.
Listen, it ain't broken or bleeding. It'll calm down. It always does. Let's go. The kid said the ward was this way. You ever hear about the North Pole?
North Pole? That old fairy tale?
Yeah, like this ward. Old white guy founds it. Food and fresh water, everyone gets along. That sounds like the fairy tale to me. It's probably just a couple old timers holed up underground. I just hope they got a few supplies for trade. Otherwise, we won't last much longer out here. You think people actually live like this?
What's... I'm not sure.
I don't know what's in that Fulton's original blend, but I never seen nobody that happy before. Not in real life. Locked. Great. Ugh, we can't turn back now. Ain't got nowhere to go. There's gotta be another way through. It's about time. What took you? What happened to these poor bastards? Can't let it go to waste. Use it on that bum ankle of yours. Won't help me none. Hey, come on. Let's get some distance between us and these bugs. Over here. Oh, this is bad. This is bad with a side of broccoli.
What the hell's that?
Nothing. Something my mom used to say.
All right, let's do this.
Nice shooting. Hey, that don't count, by the way. Starting to think looking for this ward wasn't such a good idea. Guess the deadwood ain't all gone after all.
Nope.
Ain't no way the ward's real. Not with a nest like this out here. Nope. Maybe best we head back. We retrace our steps. We can find another way out.
Here they come!
Tell me this is not happening!
It's okay. You're safe. Whoa, whoa, hold up. We're friends. We're here to help.
Can't hold this forever, Bo!
You?
Questions later. We gotta get moving. On three.
We still got each other.
Right. Follow us, you two. That won't be the last of them.
Root are thick down here.
Must be what I felt back at the ward.
Wait! You're from the ward? Maybe Santa's real, too.
Yeah, it's not far from here. But the way down collapsed behind us. We're gonna have to find another way out.
Dead would know they've lost, but they won't be down without a fight.
Bad shooting, Traveler.
Yeah, I had some practice.
I'll bet. But don't worry. Ward's as safe a place as any. Safer.
So, it's really real. Food, water, and folks living with some old white guy?
More or less.
Whoa, whoa, let me get you some water.
I'm fine!
this.
Ooh, that looks like root rot. But I've never seen a case this bad.
I'm fine. I don't know why everyone...
We need to get her to work. And quick. Doctor, there's her only chance. We'd better get moving. Or we'll lose the light.
Dear.
This is Riggler.
Call me Riggs. I got you, darling. Don't worry, friend. We'll take good care of her. Welcome to Ward 13.
Hey, don't worry. Riggs is right. She'll be fine.
Are you okay?
Just a headache.
Hey, Clementine. Let me get you some water.
I'm fine.
Oh, you're not fine. You need rest.
Bo! He's the ward's mayor. Thinks that puts him in charge of everything and everyone. Listen, I'm gonna check in with Ford, and then I'll get some rest. Okay? I've been through a lot worse, you know.
So, Traveler, your friend will be fine. I'm Bo Ward, and this is Ward 13. You must have come a long way. I mean, the route's dwindling and all, but the road's still a dangerous place. What were you two doing out there? For the ward? Really? Huh. I didn't know anybody knew what we were doing here. We've been cut off from the world for so long that... Well, I'm surprised people know about us outside the gate. Feels kind of nice, actually. Hey, ask around if you need something. Oh, start with Ford. I'm sure he'd like to meet you.
You ever climbed to the top of that tower in the city?
This... It's not up for discussion, Clementine. You're staying, and that's final.
I don't remember asking for your permission.
Watch your tone, young lady.
Excuse me? I'm 132 years old, in case you forgot. And I am not your child. You don't have authority over me.
On this, I do. We'll talk about this later.
Out of my way.
Whoa, what have we here? Ah, the Traveler, of course. Wallace said, yes, right on time. Sorry you had to see that. But then again, you've been around. I'm sure you know. Families fight. Andrew Ford. Good to make your acquaintance. In the flesh. Huh, how about that? I'm sure you've got a lot of questions, and I've got a favor to ask. So let's get to it. You first. That's a longer story than I can indulge right now. Let's keep it to this. You know how some things you drink can make you drunk, and some things you eat can make you sick or sleepy? Well, other things do this. It's... Huh. Not my way. And you want to be careful what you wish for, Traveler. All right, Traveler. Now that you've shot your shot, here's mine. I need an able young scrapper to help an old man out. Talk to Wally. You'll find him out by the docks. After that, gear up, and then meet me at the ward gate. I'll tell you a story.
See you, Traveler. You're the one Ford's been waiting for, though he doesn't know he's been waiting. He thinks he needs help. It's her who needs it. You know, and you don't. Sorry, I shouldn't say. Things get messier when I tell them. I'm Wallace. Did I say that yet? Probably. The sight, you know? Sorry, I probably said that already, too. You have a path to walk. You choose the first step here, but your path can change if you want it to. Yep, that makes a lot of sense now. You're right, of course. Your path is waiting. Tell Brabus and McCabe I sent you. They have what you need. They're the next step on your journey. Goodbye, Traveler.
Traipsing in here like you own the place. That boy what talks to the root? I don't trust Wally with a hot meal. But I also ain't dumb enough to cross him. I don't reckon he was any more specific. Right. Well, the boy's crazy, but he ain't stupid. And I can see your gear is, lacking, to say the least. If he asks, you tell him I gave you this. No charge. Riggs is gonna talk my ear off if I don't send you over to him next, isn't he?
I'll bet Riggs can help me out.
Go see Riggs then.
I should stop by.
Tell him
sometime.
He can do whatever the hell he wants.
Oh, friend. Glad to see you're all right. What can I do for you? Riggs. And no worries. There was a time when helping each other survive was all we had left. Around here, we don't forget those days if we can help it. Your friend's gonna be all right, by the way. I've seen weaker pull out of worse. What were you doing out there, if you don't mind me asking? Really? What'd you hear exactly? Ah, Founder Ford's tales travel far and wide, don't they? Fair warning. You can't believe half of them. But half of impossible is still a sight, eh? I don't suppose he was more particular about why. Ha! Yeah. That sounds like Brabus. Right. Well, I've got a pretty focused skill set. I reckon I know what he means. Come to me if you ever need to upgrade your equipment.
God and my mother. Did Bo send you over here, or did you stumble your way over here yourself? Shit. You're serious, aren't you? Alright, so what the hell is this journey? I swear, if that boy weren't so goddamn right all the time, he and I'd be having words. Percussive ones. Fine. Well, the only reason anyone bothers me is because I'm good with a hammer. So either I can modify your weapons, or we can find a more creative use for it. Tell you what, I heard you picked up something strange on your little jaunt earlier. Maybe I could do something with it. Help with whatever journey he saw you on. Just tell Wally to be more specific next time. Yeah? So we're done here, right? Or do I need the hammer again? Hopefully this means you'll be leaving soon. Look, it's not personal. I just don't like being distracted. I get into a zone, you know? Pisses me off when people come by and interrupt my me time. I'll tell you what. You're clearly not the average stray that shows up here. So I'll make you a deal. You find anything interesting out there, bring it back to me and I'll see if I can use it to mod your weapons. Okay? Oh, and if you tell anyone I was nice to you, I will cut you.
Maybe you just need... Ping brought me up.
Now you look like you could help an old man take on the world. You ready to do this? Glad to hear it. Follow me. This. Just crank the handle to make it work. This used to be a research facility, cutting edge. We did things down here nobody dreamed of. Not before nor since.
Yet, for all our manpower, we didn't know what the stones really were. Until it was too late.
The stones?
The world stones. Giant red crystals that let us see into other worlds. Even travel to them. So, what? We just hide the stones away and hope the Soviets hadn't found their own? No. We had to know everything there was to know about them. It was a matter of national security. Of pride. So, yeah. We opened the door. And walk through.
But something was waiting on the other side.
It didn't happen right away.
The inhabitants of the worlds we visited couldn't follow us. We thought we were safe. But yeah, the roof found a way. After that, well... Huh. We all know what happened after that. Locked, huh? Well, this is my house. Come on. I gave Ellen a few things to hang on to, in case of emergency. She must have hidden it around here somewhere. Come on, Ellie, where'd you hide it? That red thing. We call it a dragon heart. Don't ask why. Take it with you. You might need it. Hey, take a look at that matchbook you found. I got a hunch. Let's get this door unlocked. Can't stand around all day.
Is that the...
The World Stone. Yes. Or part of it, anyway. Every shard's as useful as the whole. We shut it down after Harsgard died. Like I told Ellen at the time, the damn thing's more dangerous than useful. Huh. Of course not. Never mind. Now, let's see if that worked.
Work to do what exactly?
To bury this place. Not just lock it away, but get some explosives and bury it in a tomb of concrete. More dangerous than useful, traveler. Remember that.
Ford? Ford!
Ford!
Oh, man. Bo is gonna be pissed.
Did it. He actually woke it up.
Clementine? Hey.
Did he tell you how to use it? Do I even want to?
System failure is imminent. The core has been compromised. The utility is required. Commencing acquisition.
Ah! Help!
Clementine!
Don't let go!
Clementine! Shit! Oh, shit! Oh, shit! Oh, no, 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 don't do it! Don't you do it! Oh, this is so stupid! Clementine! Ford! Shit. Where are you guys? This is all insane. Both Crystal and Ford. I better get moving if I'm gonna find Clementine.
What is this? Not Drazier. Some work of that damn custodian. No, no. Something else. A sentient thing. Sought, but did not see. Or perhaps, I refuse to see. Years of reflection have laid bare miracles in my mind that I never dreamed possible. Yet some things remain out of reach. Tell me, my world, precious Nerud, what has become of it? And yet you commune with me now through the speaker's pulpit. Pray tell me, how did you come by this world? No, 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 do not answer. I see it now. At the edge of my mind. But I dare not know it. You and I share this much in common, then. We are cut off from our people, and we share a similar end. Mine lies in Alepsis Tora, while yours... No. To speak it is to change it. Already it shifts. Rest assured, our fates bind us together. So I ask a favor, and will offer one in return. On the surface of this world lie several chambers that were shielded, as I was, from the cruelty of Alepsis Tora. These chambers bear the soul sparks of the Drazir, our last remaining legacy. Find them and bring them to me, but not here, not to this contemptible chamber in which you now reside. You must find me in the flesh. My temple can be found within the wastes above. Look for the all-seeing eye of the Astropaths. Bring me the soul sparks, and we will speak further. Indeed, seek the soul sparks. We will speak again.
Them if I find them. come and get some. Here they come.
Okay, this is it.
Thank you.
on!
All right, come and get some.
Thank you.
got enough of that.
Won't fit.
Okay, this is it. Great. More of that.
How unexpected. Nerud spent eons searching for life, yet now of all times you come to Nerud on your own. I have much I wish to know, but there is a more pressing task at hand. I need your help. I am the custodian, placed by the Drazir to manage and care for Nerud. One task yet remains to me, but an obstacle stands in my way. I believe you may be the solution to this obstacle. The obstacle is known as Talrotha. He possesses knowledge that I require in order to save Nerud and what remains of the Drazir. Against all reason, he opposes what I am trying to do. I cannot act without him, but I must act. I need... Unfortunately, there is only one way. You will have to dispose of Talrotha. There is no other way. He has chosen his life above all others, forcing me to make a difficult decision. Unfortunately, I cannot reach him. Only you can. To save Nerud, you will have to end his life and take the echo of his mind. Talrotha keeps himself locked within his chamber. The only thing he has is his Ambit Ember. It is what keeps him alive. This, then, will aid you. It is poisoned. Not strong enough to finish the task, but it should weaken him enough to make it easier. He only needs to consume it. Please do, and know that if you bring me his echo, you will have done a great thing for this world.
Okay, this is it. Here they come.
Reaper!
I gotta get out of this place.
Shit.